What happens when Germany sends its best general to take a small French position in North Africa? He has his troops send 40,000 shells to bombard them. How do the French reply? With 42,000 shells of their own. Hi, my name is Do Not Even Try from the channel Nomad Prod. And today, I'm effectively restarting the history-based videos. I had missed them a lot. This is gonna be a bit different. This time I am not editing them. It's gonna be my friend. And yeah, so you can take this as one of the first new history-based video that are coming on the channel. But first, I just want to shamelessly plug a little thing. I officially opened an Instagram page for my scale models. You're gonna be able to see some exclusive things such as progress build and things like that. So yeah, that's pretty cool, and I highly recommend you joining it. It's at Nomad Scale on Instagram. Anyway, let's get in the video. We are in Libya, May of 1942. The British are being pushed back through Africa by the infamous Desert Fox, General Field Marshal Aaron Rommel. Their last defensive line, Tobruk. Failing to protect this position will result in the Axis power entering Egypt, which could lead to the Germans taking the Suez Canal, which, strategically wise, is immensely important, and could result in the defeat of the British Army in North Africa. Rommel's plan is extremely simple. Fight the British on the entire line while pushing through a point in the south to flank them, resulting in the fast and easy victory that Rommel is so used to. This point, Bir Hakeim, an old ruined fortress which only has an old dry well as a point of interest. General Ritchie, leader of the British 8th Army, concedes this position to the 1st Free French Brigade. They are now responsible for its defense. The British believe that Bir Hakeim won't see much action and that Rommel will concentrate his force mainly on Tobruk. May 27th, 1942. Rommel attacks the Tobruk front as a diversion and orders the Italian to take Bir Hakeim, while him and the Afrika Korps go around and attempt a flanking maneuver. 9 o'clock a.m. Rommel gives the all clear for the Italians to attack the French defended position. The French battalion, which is composed of soldiers from all around the globe, defend the position furiously, firing artillery batteries and anti-tank guns point blank on the Italian vehicles that manage to break through the French line. In less than an hour, the Italians are pushed back. In this single hour, 32 out of the 70 tanks are lost to French fire. The Italians' Ariete division is severely crippled, and the French only lose a truck and an artillery piece while only two men are wounded. From the 29th to the 31st of May, the resistance still managed to destroy 8 other tanks, despite suffering from dehydration. The Axis has no choice except to temporarily retreat. This opens a window for the British 101st Automobile Company to deliver the water that the French desperately need. The unexpected resistance of the Force Française Libre forces Rommel to stop his advance and rethink his positions. Rommel then decides to send a division of the Afrika Korps to help the Italians to overcome the French position. On June 1st, at 10:30 a.m., two Italian officers send an ultimatum to the French lines to ask for the surrender, which, in this case, will be the logical thing to do. They fought well, but now they're surrounded. General Koenig refuses the ultimatum. The Germans know that diplomatic means won't work. They have to use force. They bombard the position with 40,000 shells. The French retaliate with 42,000. On June 6th, the Germans are 800 meters away from the French position after pushing through a minefield. By the night, Bir Hakeim is surrounded by the Axis. The French are hiding in foxholes and concrete bunkers known as blockhouse. Despite the odds, they are still pushing back the Germans. At this point, the Desert Fox has had enough. He decides to come to Bir Hakeim in person to direct the offensive. He brings tanks, troops, 88mm cannons, etc. However, it seemingly makes no difference, quoting the Desert Fox himself.
And yet the next day when my troops left, they were greeted by a violent fire, the intensity of which had not diminished since the previous day. The opponent buried himself in his individual holes and remained invisible. I needed Bir Hakeim. The fate of my army depended on it.
Rommel sent everything he has. Stukas, tanks, artillery, and yet the French took every hit and every strike fearlessly. There even is a story of one man losing a hand to an 88mm shell and still turning his 75mm gun towards the German gun
destroying it. Every time the Germans tried to break the French line, the French pushed them back. No matter what the Germans do, the valiant French do not surrender and hold their positions. But unfortunately, against such overwhelming numbers, the French couldn't defend against Rommel forever. They are running alarmingly low on ammo and food. The French are given the order to retreat. On the 10th of June, with one last fight, the Germans are held back enough to let a small battalion of French soldiers evacuate Bir Hakeim and join the British line up north at Ghaz El Abid. Their evacuation is a total success. When Rommel, still unaware that Bir Hakeim has been abandoned, attacks again, he only finds dead bodies and destroyed equipment. Rommel says,
"On June 11th, 1942, the French garnison was to receive the coup de grace. Unfortunately for us, the French did not wait. Despite the security measures we had taken, they managed to leave the fortress commanded by their leader, General König, and save a significant part of their troops. In the dark, they escaped to the west and joined the 7th English Brigade. Later, it was noted that at the place where this exit had taken place, the encirclement had not been carried out in accordance with orders received. Once again, the proof was made that the French chief determined not to throw the rifle after the sight of the first opportunity. It can achieve miracles. Even if the situation is apparently hopeless, in the morning I visited the fortress. The scene of furious fighting. We had impatiently awaited the fall. Fortification work around Bir Hakeim included. Among other things, 1,200 combat sites, both for infantry and for heavy weapons."
Bir Hakeim bought enough time for the British to set up their defenses for one of the most important battles of the Second World War, the First Battle of El Alamein, which resulted in a complete Allied victory and near annihilation of Rommel's forces. All that due to a small battalion of free French soldiers who decided that surrendering was not an option.
Anyway, I sincerely hope you have enjoyed this video. Please consider subscribing, liking, and commenting this video. And also, why not joining the Discord and interact with all the community? And I will see you next time.
Always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing.